Good morning, adventurers. It is bright and early here in Missouri. We're at the St. Louis Airport right now. Sun is just now coming up. It's about 7 a.m. Very, very early for us. Just made it through security. We are on our way to London. We have our new packs and our new gear. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Is that going to make it on the carry-on?
I think it's. I'm just hoping they're all too grumpy this morning to care.
Yeah. Next order of business is to find our gate. Actually, first, we're going to grab some Starbucks. It's going to be a bit of a hectic travel day today, guys. We have like four different planes we're flying on to make our way over to England. We're currently in St. Louis. We're heading to...
Going to Baltimore. Then Boston. And then we go to London. And from London, we take a train down to Brighton. And then a bus and or a taxi to our ultimate destination, which is Lewes. It's going to be one hell of a day.
It's going to be rough, so we're trying to just like not think too much about it.
But that's how you get the cheapest flights. We save hundreds of dollars doing this.
Check it out. Open row. What?
That's awesome.
That never happens.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of this flight crew, Southwest Airlines, welcome to Baltimore.
This is officially the coolest thing I've seen in an airport. They just have a bunch of rocking chairs set up for people to just chill and stare at the planes. That's awesome.
There's an old lady back there knitting in one. It's perfect.
I think knitting is a requirement to sitting in one of these rocking chairs.
Yeah.
One flight down, three flights to go, y'all. It's going pretty good so far, though.
Yeah, so far.
Flight is boarding and Allison actually had to hang back and order some food and it ended up taking way too long. But I think I saw her at the back of the line, so I'm gonna wait for her.
Found you.
I made it! And we're those annoying people with a whole bunch of fries and burgers. Oopsie.
But we're trying to stay healthy while we travel, okay? Because we usually eat like shit. So I got a veggie burger. What did you end up getting?
I got a veggie salad. You could put any burger on a salad.
Oh yeah, I saw that. Uh-huh. Good call. And we got some fries.
That'd be a little bad.
Veggie burger me. Well, this thing's huge.
Yeah.
Now.
Check it
out. You got brother.
Second flight is done. We are officially in Boston. Now the plan is to, we have like, what, a few hours to kill.
Yes, but now, so we're done with our domestic flights. The next is international, so I think we have to go maybe.
Yeah, we might have to go back through security. But the plan is if we can find a good spot to hunker down and get some work done for the next few hours. So I guess we have to like figure out how to get to the international terminal from here, because this is nothing but domestic flights over here.
Good thing we left a bit of a gap for these flights.
Yeah. This is why I actually like having connections, because it gives you more time to figure out where you need to go, and even if you have time to spare, you can just sit and get a lot of work done.
Yeah.
Then when you get on the plane, you can just watch a movie, because working on the plane usually sucks. At least I think so.
Yeah, like this next flight, our plan is to take a bunch of Z-Quil and knock ourselves out to hopefully combat jet lag, but
yeah.
It's never successful for us to combat jet lag, so we'll see how it goes.
We've literally had to walk a mile through this airport to get to the international terminal.
Like 15 of those.
Yeah, luckily there's been moving walkways through most of it, but it's still been about a mile. So with Wild Air, you are only allowed one carry-on. So we had to check a bag, since I have the drone bag, that's why. But I'm not gonna check this thing because they'll destroy it. So we're trying to decide which bag to check. We should probably check yours because it's bigger than mine. You think?
I think so.
Guys, I'm a little pissed. We got kind of busted at the when we went to check in the bag with Wow Air. It turns out they, before in the last like 30 days, they made a new bag policy where if your bag is bigger and it takes up more bin space, you have to pay $70 extra.
Yes, to carry it on, not even check it.
And they made me take all the stuff, because I have all this stuff attached to the sides of it. They made me take all that off and then try to stuff it into the bin and make it fit. And then they made me pay $70. And I was pretty fuming. Luckily she was here and kept a cool head. And the reason they do this policy is because they think that a bigger bag like mine has to fit like horizontal in the bin and not just slide right in, you know, depth wise. But I know that my bag will fit in that bin.
Because it just fit on the Southwest bin.
I don't think their bins are any smaller. So I was telling them like, this damn bag will fit. All right, I'm not paying $70. But they wouldn't take no for an answer.
But on the plus side, we got rocking chairs in this airport.
Yeah.
Who knew?
We got the rocking chairs.
That's the new trend in airports.
Guys, I'm trying to be more positive in my life. So I'm trying to not let that get me down.
2017.
It's a new year, and I'm going to get screwed this year just like every other year. But it all depends on how you react to getting screwed.
Yeah, like we found out our flight's delayed. Cool, more time to enjoy
more time to chill and hang with each other. I'm beyond hungry at this point. I'm trying to decide, pizza or something healthy. So I ended up compromising and getting the best of both worlds. Veggie pizza, also a huge hunk of steamed vegetables for a side. That's a good pizza. So we've got some Z-Quil that we were gonna take so we can sleep on this flight. But we're trying to decide if we should take two or just one, because we don't wanna be like...
It's only 5 hours.
Yeah, it's only 5 hours. And then we have a connecting flight in Reykjavik. So I don't wanna be walking through the airport all drowsy. We're trying to Google it to figure out how it's gonna affect us. And the top search term is how much Z-Quil will kill me.
I'm hoping that's preventative and not intentional.
Yeah. Look, it's my bag, and what do you know? It fit in there long ways. I didn't have to turn it horizontal.
What do you know, Bear?
Wow. I just did that.
Let's check out this neck pillow I got.
Yeah, believe it or not, this is a neck pillow. It looks like a giant penis. I'm not gonna lie. Check this thing out.
Like a
if I didn't know that was a neck pillow, I would have no clue what the hell it is.
Hey, from the,
Okay, guys, our plane is about to take off, so we're about to hunker down and see if we can at least get a little bit of sleep before we land in Reykjavik.
Yes. Just one Z-Quil apiece. So
yeah, we decided to take one Z-Quil because we were afraid to take two. We were afraid we'd be too groggy on the other end.
Yeah. We'll let you know how that goes.
All right, next time we see you, I guess we'll be in Reykjavik.
Good night, adventurers.
See you on the road.